pretty easy, right? Now, what about those two self-adhesive squares in the box? Playing in my next video, check the description for details. In my last video, I promised to talk about these two little self-adhesive squares that come in the package. What are they for? Well, I figured the best way to find out was to ask the seller directly. So I sent them a message. I would like to ask, what is the purpose of the adhesive squares inside the package? How are they supposed to be used? Their response. Answer is surprising for me, but still interesting. The adhesive squares included in your package are designed for specific applications such as securing items or providing additional support. They can be used to attach or stabilize components as needed. Sounds vague, right? Hello everyone and welcome back to the very excited video blog. I took a closer look at these two self-adhesive squares and realized that these are heatsinks for the SSD drive. When open up the case, you'll see that the lid is actually a heatsink, and that's important because the Realtek RTL927B controller inside this solid drive gets crazy hot. How hot? Around 80-90 degrees when it's really working hard. While read speeds seem fine, beads suffer, maxing out around 2400 to 500 megabytes per second, which is way the drives than the drive's full potential. Be real, sticking an SSD to the back of an iPhone, bad idea. Without proper cooling, the solid drive heats up, and if the case reaches 60, 70 degree, it could actually damage iPhone. Or there is a high probability of this, I think. Here's how to fix it to keep performance high and prevent thermal throttling. Install those heatsinks, thermal pads correctly. Open up the case. Cut the thermal pads into two separate pieces, one for the memory chip and one for the Realtek controller. It would be a mistake to cover two large chips with one thermal pad. This is the memory and the Realtek controller itself. If you do this, the effectiveness of the thermal pads decreases. Therefore, it is necessary to cut out two separate rectangles and stick them on these chips. Close the case and don't open again. Done. Now this SSD is good to go. Cooler, faster, and ready to handle heavy workloads without slowing down. The best way to say thank you to the author is to share this video with your friends. I'll hope to see you next time. Bye.